Hi guys, a very warm welcome from RJP Creations. Today we are going to be starting a new course on Gond Art. Now this is a course on Gond Art for beginners. This is our third course for beginners. We have already covered a course on Varli for beginners, Madhubani for beginners, and now we are going to do Gond for beginners. In case you've missed out the Varli and the Madhubani course for beginners, I have mentioned the links in the description box. You can find the links to the videos there. Now, as far as Gond Art is concerned, this is a 6-day course or a 6-series course for the beginners. In this course, we are going to learn the various motifs of Gond Art, that is the peacock, the fish, the elephant. Also, we will be learning how to do the human figures in Gond Art. Now, this video of today is divided into 3 parts. We will learn about the history of Gond Art. Then we will learn what all material we will require for doing the 6 series, and we will also learn how to create the basic filler patterns for Gond Art. So let us discuss each topic individually. Let us start with introduction to Gond Art. Now the history of Gond Art. Gond Art paintings were done by the largest tribe in central India, who were predominantly centered in Madhya Pradesh but were spread over MP, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh and Orissa. Gond basically comes from a Dravidian word which means Kond, meaning green mountains. Now these beautiful Gond paintings were done on both the inner and the outer walls and the floors of the people in their houses. They used to use digma. Digma basically means geometric patterns like lines, dots, spirals, and Bhitti Chitra, which means that they would ideally make flora, fauna, animals, birds and humans. Traditionally, the Gond people would use vegetable and mineral dyes made from natural flowers, leaves, clay, stone, rice, turmeric to make various colors for the paintings. And guess what did they use for brushes? They would use the neem or babool twigs, and on top of the twigs they would tie rags or pieces of cloth to make the tips of their brushes. It was only post 1981 that Gond Art was made on paper or on canvas. Now let us understand some distinct features of Gond Art. In Gond Art, symmetry and balance plays a very significant role. All the trees, leaves, animals, birds and humans have a lot of intricate pattern work, and we will be learning this in detail while we are doing the series. Second is, a lot of bright, vibrant colors were used. So largely red, blue, yellow, green and whites were used. Nature is very important in Gond Art, and almost everything is depicted in relation or in connection to nature. Nature was regarded as very sacred. And majority of the paintings were based on folktales and rituals and man's close connection to nature. You will find that pattern work is extremely important in Gond Art. So there is a lot of use of dots, dashes, lines, spirals, etc. And it is the artist's creativity who put together these long lines and dots very creatively. Another important aspect is that both inner lines and outer lines are drawn with a lot of perfection, and intricate details are drawn in all the items that we draw in Gond Art. And we will be learning some filler patterns in today's lesson as well. Now, before we go ahead, let us learn about the material that will be required by you. Now, let us discuss what all materials are required for the 6-day beginner course. Now, in this course, I have used an A5 size sheet. So, we need 6 A5 size sheets. Now, this is a normal sketchbook of A5 size. If you have this is fine, or you can use any cartridge or ivory A4 sheet and just divide the sheets into half. So you will need 6 A5 size sheets. The second most important thing are the colors. For this I have used acrylic colors. So I have larger bottles of acrylic colors available with me. Otherwise you can even take smaller bottles, or you can take the acrylic complete kit which is available. In this, we'll be using almost all colors like red, we'll need black, we'll need a shade of green, a shade of blue, we'll need a shade of white, then we'll need orange, we'll need yellow and we'll need a shade of brown. So if you have colors with you, you can mix and match your acrylic colors, or you can take a small box of acrylic colors which is available. Primarily the 3-4 brushes that you need is, one brush which is very important is a 00. See, I'll show you, this is a 00 or a 000 brush is important. Other than that, you can take any 3-4 brushes of 2-number, 4-number, 6-number which are available with you. The next very important thing is the Micron pens. It is better that you get Micron or any fine tip pens which are waterproof and fade proof. For this particular form of art, we will not be able to use normal gel pens because we'll be using the Micron pens or your fine tip pens on top of your acrylic colors. So I have used mainly 3 Micron pens here. One is a 0.4 or a 0.3. The second is a thinner Micron pen, that is a 005. One is a thicker pen, which is, here I have used a Brasto Technical 0.8, or you can use a Micron 0.8. You will also be needing a Sakura. This is a, let me get it closer. This is a jelly roll Sakura white pen. So white pen also we will be using in some part of our filler patterns and design. If you have colored pens packet available with you, any company colored pens packet is also important, because in some parts of the gold painting we will also be using colored pens for doing our designing work. You will need, of course, a scale, a pencil and a rub. So this is largely what is the material that is required. I have mentioned the links of all the material that is required for the course even in the description box. Those are Amazon links in case you want to purchase online. Now let us learn how to make basic filler patterns for gold. Now let us learn some Gondart filler patterns. Now here I have made 12 boxes. The dimensions of the box is 2 cm by 4 cm. You can make any size of your boxes and practice these filler patterns, because the more you practice the filler patterns, the better your paintings will. So the first filler pattern for Gondart paintings, which is very popular, is a dotting. So just practice dotting. So first is, the dotting should be very close to each other. The second is how the dotting should be scattered. So in one part of the box you practice dotting which is very close to each other, like this. And in the other part just practice dotting which is very scattered. We will be using various kinds of dottings when we are doing our gold paint. The second filler pattern which is very popular are dashes. So just practice dashes. These are little taller dashes which have longer lines. So practice few dashes with longer lines, practice few dashes with smaller lines. The same way, longer dashes. The next filler patterns are lines. So first I'm just drawing straight these horizontal lines. Just make sure that when you're drawing the horizontal lines, the distance between the lines is similar and your lines are as straight as possible. So when you're practicing, don't use a scale, just try to draw as straight lines as you can. Like this. Next is, we are just going to divide this into two parts and we are going to practice slanting lines of both types. In the same way, practice slanting lines of the other way, other side also. Like this. Next comes semicircles. So here what we are going to do is make a dot here, a bigger dot, and three semicircles. A dot, then three semicircles. This is quite a popular pattern which is used as a filler. Like this. Next is dash and dot. So you can practice it in various sizes of your dashes. Let me just finish and show you. Now, since this pattern is going to be used in the bodies of the animals, humans, leaves, etc., so that you should practice using different sizes of the dots. Now, next is we have done sleeping lines, we need to do vertical lines. Now next is just divide this and practice curves. Now in this you can practice deeper curves. Okay. And in this in between size. Now next is we are going to combine the curve and the dot. So it is going to be two curves, then a line of dots, then curves, then a line of dots. This with dots. So the same pattern you can have with dots also. So here curve, so it's basically like two curves or three curves, then dots, and then line, then three curves like this, then dots, line, three curves like this, dots, line. Now, in this, just practice the leaf, the eye shape. Now, generally, we will never leave the leaves blank, so you will always have these lining on both sides. Now, next is draw semicircles. Draw a circle here and connect it through these lines. Like this. And another pattern is we are drawing like this shape. And just divide it, not full, and we are going to do these shade lines facing inside this way. Let me finish these and show you. So now you can see that the filler patterns are done. Do practice the filler patterns so that you can make better paintings of Gond. Now that you've learned about Gond art, the history of Gond art, as well as the material that we require for the complete course on Gond art, and how to make the various filler patterns, do practice your patterns for the series to start. Practice your filler patterns and stay tuned for the main lessons of Gond art for beginners. Thank you so much for watching. Do like our video, do subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to press the notification button so that you can be notified as soon as we start the Gond art course. Thank you and bye-bye.